I'm an endocrinologist. I am former director of the Department of Endocrinology and Diabetes at the Alfred Hospital in Melbourne. I'm a professor of medicine at Monash University. I've had almost 50 years of involvement in thyroid research, autoimmunity, diagnostic techniques, thyroid nodules and cancer. I've worked in Canada and the USA on these matters. I'm a former president of the Endocrine Society of Australia. I remain a councillor of the Asia and Oceania Thyroid Association. I'm currently an editor, one of the editors of the Journal of Clinical Endocrinology, which is one of the major global endocrine journals in the world. I'm continuing to work in the clinical care of patients with thyroid disease, and I am a medical advisor to the Australian Thyroid Foundation. There is certainly some misinformation, but I think primarily there's a sort of a lack of information on the importance of iodine and thyroid function in growth and development. So particularly the issue in pregnancy and in infancy, and particularly its role in optimizing brain function, maximizing human potential. But it's important throughout life, in childhood and in adolescence, young adulthood, through into old age. So I think there's a profound importance of iodine supplementation in certain components, particularly pregnancy and breastfeeding. And I don't think that in general people appreciate that. So I think that's the first aspect. It's a matter of lack of information, a lack of information on the importance of using iodized salt, if you're using iodine salt in cooking and at the table, and that we should always use iodized salt. And I think that we have to buy this in the supermarket. There is some iodization of some foodstuffs, such as breads, but I think that that's an area where there is lack of information about the importance of iodine and thyroid function. Where there is misinformation, I think, is that there's a tendency for people to want to use non-dairy forms of milk, almond milk, etc., which do not have an adequate nutritional component in regard to iodine. And also people perhaps want to use salt that is not iodized, and things like Himalayan salt. Now, Himalayan salt is mined in Pakistan. It doesn't contain any iodine. It's got a little bit of iron contamination, so it looks a little bit pink, very, very nice looking, but it's really not appropriate. And I think people have a misinformation that somehow these forms of salt are better. They're not. We really need to concentrate on iodized salt. And I think people perhaps don't understand where they can get to, they can purchase iodized salt easily in the supermarket. They need to know that dairy food is a good source of iodine, as well as other foodstuffs, particularly seafoods. So I think that the need for supplementation and breastfeeding in pregnancy is very important, so that the baby's thyroid function will be optimized. And I think that's the area that I think is of great importance. But it's important for all people, and maintains importance of thyroid function throughout life. Healthcare professionals do need some assistance, and I think this is very important in the intentions of the Australian Thyroid Foundation initiative. There is an awareness of thyroid disease amongst general practitioners and nurses, but I think it could be improved, and we could assist those healthcare professionals to be able to better inform and educate the people that they see. So I think that there is a need for more information to assist healthcare professionals. I mean, the Australian Foundation, Thyroid Foundation, intends to have a broad campaign directed at the community, so focusing on young families, but also to develop educational toolkits for healthcare professionals, which I think will be focused on the general practitioner, upon say, midwives, nursing profession, people that have contact with young women who are contemplating pregnancy in particular, but any healthcare professional who's seeing people throughout life, including later life, geriatricians. We need to give people more resources in a way that is accessible to both the community, the patient, and also to the healthcare professionals. So focusing not just on providing information via the ATF website, but other, want to go out more to reach people in better ways.